Corpus! Hey! What up, bro?
What's going on?
How you been?
Welcome to Scarhouse.
So, I heard you guys got some video ideas for Banquet.
Alright, guys, let me do the honor and go first. Alright, check it out, Corpus. We all know that the first and second year has been rough, right? It's been hard. So I think what we need to do is give an inspirational video. One to kind of encourage the incoming classes, maybe in the first year classes.
Walk me through what you're thinking then.
Montage. With 80s rock music. Okay? Picture this. Free sitting in a classroom, studying, smelling good. Kind of boring, right? Now add some rocky music. Bam! Instant motivation.
Okay, okay. Mix it up with some people working out and just running for no good reason. Yeah, I like it, I like it.
Exactly. Now, the montage just takes care of itself. Check it out. Remember those ACLS videos? What if we did those, but ECM? Okay, so we open up with the same dramatic scenes with the helicopters spinning and everything, and then coming in and with the guy on the gurney and all that.
Right, right.
And we use the host. Here, this is the part. The host is everybody's favorite TV actor, Norm from Cheers.
Norm from Cheers is in this video?
Or someone that looks like him.
Being able to successfully complete a patient encounter in ECM requires a careful combination of both clinical competence and clear communication skills. A proper encounter usually consists of starting with an open-ended question, building rapport, setting the agenda, and always show empathy. Let's take a look at how to properly greet our patient.
Hi,
Hi, I'm student Dr. Adrian Estes. How are you today?
Hi, I'm okay.
Good, good. What's your name?
Lisa.
Lisa, it's a pleasure to meet you.
Yeah.
So tell me about yourself. Where are you from?
I'm from Oklahoma.
Oh, okay. That's very, very nice. So what brings you in today, Lisa?
I'm here for a follow-up. I've got these recurrent UTIs.
Okay, no problem. What we'll do is we'll do a physical exam and I'll take some history questions, okay?
Okay.
Nice job. But let's see how our next student doctor does.
So, Kelly, what brings you in today?
I'm Lisa.
Oh, Lisa, I'm so sorry. I just came back from lunch, had a little drink, a little bit tired. So what brings you in today?
I'm here for a follow-up for a UTI.
That's awful. Oh my god, how long have you had that?
For about a couple weeks now.
Wow, that sucks. I hate when that happens. Thank you. Thank you. You're a good purse holder.
One thing to avoid during your encounter, refrain from calling your patient a good purse holder. She's a great purse holder.
And can you describe kind of to me how does it feel? How would you describe it?
It's kind of a burning pain, kind of just down here.
Okay. And does the pain radiate anywhere?
As you can see, his history taking was as nice as his bow tie. But here, we'll see a perfect example of a disastrous physical exam.
So what's going on today?
I'm here for a follow-up for my recurrent UTIs.
UTIs. I can check out your eyes.
Okay.
So what I'm gonna have you do is look over my right shoulder. Isn't that for the ears?
An otoscope to the eyes? The rare ocular UTI should be very low on the differentials list. Now let's see how our doctors deal with a patient suffering from alopecia.
Hi, I'm student doctor.
Nice. So smooth. What do you use?
Shampoo.
Shampoo?
Yeah.
I could never get my legs this smooth with shampoo.
You'd be surprised, actually.
You know what? I need a picture of this. My girlfriend's never gonna believe this. Put your head down.
Rule number 309.105A, never take a picture of you with your patient's condition and send it to your girlfriends unless it's a hidden camera. Student Dr. Stastny, what should we do next?
All right, so we're gonna go ahead and do a physical exam, check you out, kind of see what we can find, head to toe, and we'll go from there.
Okay.
All right.
Notice how our German friend set the agenda and let the patient know what's next. Now, how don't we want to approach this patient?
Oh my, it's so bright in here. I need to put my sunglasses on. Do you mind just put your head down, please, for me? Just for a second.
Is that gonna help you know?
I just forgot my mirror in my purse. I just need to check my teeth and make sure there's no lipstick.
Yeah, I get that all the time, and that's what I'm really worried about.
Yeah, you know what? I like it. It's like a portable mirror. You must pull in a lot of ladies.
I do.
Yeah.
I didn't think it was that reason,
though. This is perfect. You're like a pocket mirror. I should carry you around everywhere.
If you're keeping track at home, this particular student doctor has now called her patient a good purse holder and a pocket mirror. Rude and inaccurate. His head would never fit in a pocket. So what should we do?
Have you noticed any bumps or bruises or anything like that?
No.
Okay, all right, well, I'm just looking to see. Do you feel like it falls out really easily?
It's not there anymore.
That's good.
Another excellent evaluation by student Dr. Estes. So far, the patients have been fairly easy to deal with. But let's consider the next case. This young man appeared on an MTV reality show entitled True Life a year ago, and has since gone into a downward spiral of insanity. Let's take a look.
Hi, I'm student Dr. Adriana. I'm so sorry.
State your name and purpose, please.
I'm student Dr. Adriana Estes. I come to see you.
No.
Notice how she stayed calm and didn't panic. But what kind of a train wreck can we expect when our other student doctors try and evaluate this patient?
Oh my Chanel, look! Our things match. Isn't this perfect? Oh my god. Don't get crazy with me.
Never tell your mentally unstable patient to not get crazy. He he knows he's crazy. What kind of things can we expect on physical exam?
Floppy, could you ask Josh to maybe put his finger on mine and kind of do like a nose-to-finger movement? Okay. That's pretty good. Excellent. All right. And do you think Josh can take his heel and just wrap it up and down his chin?
Very good. Nose-to-finger test to assess our patient's cerebellar function? Intact. And I'm certain our student doctor meant to say to take his heel and rub it up and down his shin, not chin. Unless, of course, he could indeed rub his heel up and down his chin. In which case, I would be thoroughly impressed.
Hey, honey. I did not sign up for this. Where's my attending? Dr. John!
Yes, you did sign up for this, student Dr. DeoGracias. Surprise! Remember, the success of an ECM encounter is built on a strong foundation of proper communication, genuine empathy, and an overall desire to treat and to do no harm to your patients. Keeping in mind what to do and what not to do will help you go a long way, not only in this course, but also in your career as a doctor of podiatric medicine and surgery.
Boom! Best video ever.
No way, it was whack.
Dude, you give the people what they want. First year, Trevor Black. Second year, they want seconds.
I don't know. Anyway, you would do something about school. But anyways, Corvus, check this out. This is my idea. How about we do like an NFL, NBA draft, a sports draft, but of residency.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to this year's class 2013 residency draft. I'm your host, Chris Jones. Joining with me, my partner.
I'm Seth, the Big Bunyan Brazier.
So Bunyan, what's your take on this year's draft?
Well, after a surprising season of 38 students, we're down to just two 12 packs. And if you ask me, that number should be quite lower. But apart from all this, we got one strong person in this draft, one game changer that I think will blow everyone out of their minds.
Couldn't agree more, Bunyan. She is the talk of this year's draft, reigning from the Congo and modeling her game after Kobe the Black Mamba Bryant, Sonya the Black Mwemba. Resume boasts a mean 4.5 GPA and some mad fixation skills. Past achievements include APGAR score 11 out of 10. She drew diamonds as a three-year-old, reinvented the Lapidus, and is now known as the Mwemba.
Well, Chris, seems like we have a regular Bunyanette.
And we'll have Ish. She's going to be an ESPN analyst because, frankly, she is an ESPN analyst.
Thanks, guys. Like you said, this year's draft's not very deep. I think we all know who's going to go number one. I think the commissioner is coming down, so let's take a look.
Word is Commissioner Jackson's coming to the pulpit.
Man, if he was a girl, he'd be late every month.
Seems like Commissioner Jackson running a little behind schedule. Oh! Looking a little disheveled as usual.
And with a Big Mac.
All right, with the first pick.
Here's the announcement.
Draft, all of you residency would like to select Stephen Law from WesternU.
Wow, holy Alex. Stephen who? Didn't see that coming, Bunyan.
Man, my bunions are bursting with excitement here. I'm hotter than a gouty arthritic toe.
Well, you can just smell the excitement.
Yeah, I sure smell something in there.
Oh, look at the reaction on that kid's face. Exciting day for the Law family.
Man, this kid came out of nowhere. I don't even know his name.
A round of boba for everyone.
A round of what?
Boba, you know, the little gummy drink.
Oh, it must be a Vietnamese thing, huh? Man, the Cambodian Camp Cobra. I can't even say that name.
Oh, the Cambodian nation must be going nuts right now, Bunyan.
Where did he come from?
Can you picture the scene? Pandemonium and donut stores across the nation.
Man, what an exciting day.
Oh, doesn't he look adorable in that little hat?
Man, if you're my kid, I'd give him a big kiss right now.
The man of the hour,
Tyson,
Stephen,
you crazy,
Law.
Man. You crazy. We did it.
Stephen, how are you feeling?
I'm feeling great. I'm feeling great. Dish. I'm feeling great, Dish.
Stephen, your mom looks so excited. How are you feeling?
Oh, no, hi. He very good boy. He studied all the time.
Mom, you're embarrassing me.
Never go out. Study.
Mom.
He very good boy.
Stephen, so now that you're the number one pick, what can all of you expect from you?
Well, Leash, I know there's big expectations put on top of me, but what can I say? You know, I'm the number one pick for a reason. They call me the Cambodian Cobra. You know, I'm gonna take this residency spot to the top. All of you, baby, all of you.
Oh, Kanto. We work on.
We did it, Mom. We did it.
Okay. All right, guys. Back to you.
With the second pick in the draft, Arrowhead Residency would like to select Sonia Mwumba.
All right. Here's the reaction from the green room. Sonia, the Black Mwumba, second pick from Arrowhead.
I mean, you can just tell by that gait. She's just utterly distraught.
Terribly disappointed. So many high expectations for this young, just thrilling draftee from the Congo.
I mean, she reminds me of Madame Beckler coming out of the exam, just totally destroyed. I don't know if we can pick up the pieces of that one.
Congratulations, Sonia.
Whatever.
I'm here with Sonia. Sonia, what do you think happened? Why did you go number two?
I have no idea. I don't know. I'm really pissed right now. I think that they made a big mistake and they're gonna pay for it.
For the eighth selection of the draft, all of you residency would like to select Cyrus Serker.
And here's a reaction from Cyrus
What? What's that now? Circus. It looks like by the way he's dancing, he's from the circus. I don't know. Man, this guy just happened to be here. I don't think he realized he can survive these 2 years. Just pure excitement. That's just what it's all about right there.
Congratulations.
Hi, I have our number eight pick here, Cyrus. Cyrus, how do you feel being the number eight?
I'm just happy to be here.
That's good. So, Cyrus, how are you going to contribute to all of you?
Just happy to be here, man.
All right, well, he's obviously very happy, so back to you guys.
And finally, the 24th pick of the draft, all of you residency would like to select Tyson Carter.
All right, well, no surprises here, Bunyan. Coming in at the last pick, Tyson Carter.
Yeah, and I gotta say, you know, if I hadn't been studying for a test all week, I would not cheat on his paper, that's for sure.
I just hope he doesn't get any endocrine exams in his residency.
Man, I don't know what to say. That's, you know, what a surprise.
Oh, wow, a little awkward moment there.
What, is he trying to get the Jinjin Ninja? Kiss, huh?
No surprises.
That kid is awkward written all over him.
All right, I have our 24th pick here. So, Tyson, how do you feel?
I feel good. I feel like it's a little bit low, but it's well-deserved for all the hard work that I've put in, so.
Great. So how you can contribute to all of you?
Well, I think there's a few tricks I have up my sleeve that all of you has not seen yet. You never know when the Jinja Ninja will strike next.
All right, awesome, guys, back to you.
Wow, breaking news here, Bunyan. I can't believe what I'm hearing. In a 3-for-1 trade, all of you has traded all of its draftees to Arrowhead for the Black Mwumba.
You know, Chris, this doesn't surprise me. The Black Mwumba, she is undeniable. You cannot surpass her. These three wannabes over here, they have nothing compared to the Black
scrubs.
Mwumba.
Scrubs. They don't want no scrubs.
Incredible. And I'm not surprised by this turn of events. I said, you know, years ago, she was the number one pick, and I'm still sticking to that.
Well, let's do this, Benny. Let's go down to Ish for a reaction with the Black Mwumba and the other draftees.
Let's go.
Thanks, guys. I'm here with our former number one pick and our former number two pick. This just in, all of you has traded these three guys for this one Sonia. Sonia, how are you feeling?
Very happy, extremely happy. I couldn't be happier. They finally got it right.
Good. Why do you think they changed their mind?
I just think they came to their senses that the Cambodia Cobra cannot beat the Black Mwumba, so I think it came down to it.
Great, awesome. Steven, how are you feeling?
Well, Leash, I am disappointed, but...
Ish.
Sorry, Leash. I am disappointed, but you know what? Her GPA does top all of ours combined. But you know, like I said, I'm just disappointed.
Cyrus, how are you feeling?
I'm just happy to be here.
Happy guy. Tyson, how are you feeling?
The Jinja Ninja would like a birth certificate check.
All right, thanks guys. Back to you.
Well, folks, that's it for the class of 2013 residency draft. It's been an exciting day, wouldn't you say, Bunyan?
Oh, it's been mind-blowing.
All right, folks, well,
we're gonna say goodnight to you. Keep your STJs in neutral.
Remember, as I sign off, that ye are the salt of the earth. Ask, seek, and knock. Home run. Touchdown. Back to you.
Ba-ba-ba-ba-bam! And that's what we call golden. Brett, your draft idea is so stupid. What are you wearing, by the way?
So, what'd you think?
Pretty good.
Pretty good,
pretty
right?
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 Yeah.
I mean, if I could be honest, I really didn't like any of that.
Alright, that's cool.
I mean, it didn't really work
that hard. Yeah, it wasn't whatever you think that hard about
not
it.
Not an A for effort.
Yeah, kinda.
Oops, all berries! What do you want to do now?
Happy hour?
Happy hour.
Aha! Happy hour, let's go!
You're not gonna bring that sweater with you, Brett, are you?
Follow it for UTI? Wait, cut, hold on.
Do something about. Fool, shut up!
This season we're down to 2 12 packs. And
Dan, we'll run.
Yeah, go ahead. You good?
Rinse?
Mom! Mom! Let go!
My son! He's so smart!
Yes, you did sign up for the student doctors.
Okay, okay, and then you mix it up with some.
He's gonna show up late with some goodies.
At golf school, I have like procedures named out of me, after me.
Okay, all right. Thank you, Sonia. Back to you guys.
That's the number one reason why I wear this. Just to keep him out of my head.
Okay.
He's always in my head. Unless I wear this.
Does he have a name?
Dr. Jones.
Well, Leisha, you know, Sonia may be the Black Mamba, but they call me the Cambodian Cobra. I'm trying to bring this, I don't know, olive rest. I don't know.
They said it's a... I forgot what I said.
Residency would like to take Sonia Mwivimbla.
Good.
Yeah. Let me read the card. And the draft should be right about now as Commissioner Van Jackson chooses a Black Mwemba.
Analyst. She's definitely in the wrong career. Cause she... Her,
I was...
I'm going for it.